Hi, in this lesson, I'm going to share with you a couple of tweaks to the traditional open house that will undoubtedly improve your conversion rates, your productivity, as well as your profit. So the traditional open house, a real estate agent is going to put out maybe two or three signs. Now let's recognize that you get out of things what you put into things. So the more signage you have, the more attention is going to be drawn to the open house and the more people you're going to get engaged with it. Do a neighborhood only open house from 11 to 12. And from 12 to 3, it's a general public open house. See, many of the people in the neighborhood would love to come to your open house, yet they feel a little bit awkward. Yet if you invite them directly to attend and only the neighbors are going to be there, chances are they're going to feel more comfortable and more confident being able to go in and tour the inside of their neighbor's home. Now, prior to the open house, I'm also going to encourage you to go around the neighborhood, preview every other listing within that neighborhood, take copious notes, invite your lender to attend the open house with you. When a prospect shows up at the open house, of course, you'll hand them a survey on a clipboard that'll ask all the qualifying questions that you need to know, such as what price range they're comfortable with. And let's answer the question, do buyers look at open houses that they can't afford? Yes or yes, of course they do. So you gotta get their price range, how many bedrooms they're looking for, how many bathrooms they're looking for, are they pre-approved for their mortgage? How soon do they wanna purchase a home? Are they working with another agent? All of those questions should be on your survey. Now, when they complete the survey appropriately, you know if you want to follow up with this prospect during the open house. So you can approach the prospect and say, how does this home compare to others you've seen? How would you rate it on a scale of 1 to 10? And anything less than a 10, you'd say, what would you change about this home to make it a 10? And they say, well, we need a bigger kitchen or we need a bigger backyard. Because you've previewed the other homes within the neighborhood, you can say, you know what, based on what you just said, the home right around the corner at 123 Main Street, that actually meets your needs better than the one we're in. Have you got 5 minutes right now? I'll run over and show it to you immediately. So you're switching them from the open house that they're looking at to run over and show them another house. Your lender's at the open house, so they'll babysit the open house while you're gone. Now here's something I suggest that you write down. For your open house, I want you to bring a laptop. I want you to have Wi-Fi access. Also, bring an inkjet printer with you, the type you can buy over at Office Depot for just $79. It's lightweight, it's portable, and I want you to bring that to the open house with you. When the prospect comes in, they fill out the form. Let's say you're holding a $350,000 home open. They can only qualify up to $300,000. If you let them leave, you're dead in the water. Rather, you've got your laptop there. So based on their criteria, what they've completed on the survey, you say, I'll tell you what, let's do. I'd like to just input your criteria into the multiple listing service platform. In a matter of moments, I'll be able to tell you exactly how many properties match your unique criteria, and I can print the list for you right here, right now. So tell me, what part of town are you most interested in? How many bedrooms do you need? How many bathrooms? How many car garage? Newer home, older home, any particular style of home? And you're inputting this data into the MLS platform. And then you click the how many button. Let's say there's 10. Go ahead and print all 10 of them. And then I'm gonna ask you to give them an assignment to take these forms and create an A list of properties, means these are the ones you wanna see the inside of. A B list of properties, these means it's not right for one reason or another. Yet once you've got that A list of properties, and you've positioned yourself to possess something that the prospect wants, let me ask, how easy is it to set an appointment? It's super simple. So guys, I trust you're gonna take these little tweaks to your traditional open house and improve your conversion rates, improve your effectiveness, and increase your profit.